journals mention working horses frequently in the 1850s. In what was then the West, but is now the Midwest, organs were used to pull stagecoaches, perform light farm work, and as buggy and wagon horses. The Morgan's ability to thrive on a limited amount of feed was a boon to settlers attempting to scratch out an existence on their new farms. In the ring, demonstrating lock pulling, is Sherry Johnson with 11-year-old Whirlwind's Admiral. Though not used much in this capacity today, lock pulling was a necessity for early settlers, and Morgan's excelled at it. It was strong enough to pull the heavy flood logs that had been hauled to make way for pigs, and were hardy enough to navigate the tight spaces of forest in transition and all the stumps and brush that came with that territory. Last year at this event, Sherry used Admiral to demonstrate the Morgan's use as a prize mount for the Pony Express in Buffalo Bill Delivers. 21 hours, 21 Morgans, one Pony Express adventure. It says, wanted, young, skinny, wiry fellows, not over 18, must be expert riders, willing to risk their daily. Orphans prefer. The advertisement could not have been more clear. This was how legends were born. The Pony Express wasn't just a mail delivery service. It was a perilous mission that knit together the coast of a growing nation. A testament to the bravery, durability, and pure strength of the men and horses that ran it. The physical traits required for a Pony Express mount were made clear. Stamina, strength, and excellent feet were a necessity, and the Morgan was an obvious favorite. Buffalo Bill Cody completed 322 miles in 21 hours and 40 minutes, using 21 different Morgans, one of his proudest achievements. The National Museum of the Morgan Horse, located in Middlebury, Vermont, told us that Morgans also became a popular cavalry mount. At the start of the Civil War, the 2nd and 3rd Michigan Cavalry were mounted on Morgan horses under General Bill Sheridan's Mount Winchester, also known as Rienzi. A black horse is known for his famous 20-mile dash to rally his troops. This was immortalized in Thomas Buchanan Reed's poem, appropriately titled Sheridan's Ride. Vermont cavalry, more commonly called the Green Mountain Boys, were all mounted on Morgan horses.
Beautiful.
At the turn of the 20th century, horses were used less and less for the job of taking their owners to town. The advent of the automobile meant Morgan horses were carriers for purely pleasure, not for work-related transport. Entering the ring is Val Jones, Grim Crows, Imagine, an 11-year-old man. Though colonialists love common color in the Morgan breed, it is allowed, and when it occurs, it makes for a striking turnout. Morgans are a big part of today's driving world. They excel in all phases of competitive driving, having the stamina, the marathon, the movement and obedience for dressage, and the speed and agility for promos. Don't be fooled by their small size. They compete on equal footing with the larger harness horses. In fact, Morgans were the first American breed to compete in the World Reserve Driving Competition, representing the United States. Though very few are used on the farm anymore, the versatility of the Morgan has helped to find its place in today's world. Riding country pleasure is Karen Gardner on Gulfwind Centerfold, a regional champion in hand and a champion country pleasure mare. Following Karen is Gina Rogers, riding amateur Western pleasure mare, Gulfwind, Annabelle Lee. Audrey Wilford, writing English on her 8-year-old gelding, Valamar Sedaro Adonis. Writing Western is Larry Frederick on Anastasia in Havana, age 21. With him and behind him is Brianna Gray, age 11, writing English on LSN DV Star with a 10-year-old mirror. Writing Western on Wachusett Belfer, a 14-year-old mayor, is Savannah Centers, age 14. Lastly, we have Nancy Adams, representing the support course disciplines on Bruce Bruce's photo, her 16-year-old gelding. Nancy hopes that you all forgive her for not showing more polished massage moves. It's just that this horse rider team spends more time working paddling than an English tack. Morgans excel in all disciplines, including, but not limited to, endurance, combined driving, massage, reining, saddle seat, and working counters. They make excellent pleasure mounts for those who like to trail ride or drive and are sane, sound, easy keepers in backyards across America. Morgans make superior duke mounts due to their loving nature and willingness to please. They are blessed with an extreme amount of sensibility, too. The Morgan horse has the distinction of being the first recognized American breed, originating in 1789. With more than 150,000 names recorded in the official register, Morgans can be found in all 50 states and in many foreign countries. Founded in 1909, the American Morgan Horse Association is a not-for-profit organization serving more than 47,000 Morgan horse owners, breeders, exhibitors, and enthusiasts throughout the United States. The Alabama Morgan Horse Club was founded in 1980. We invite you to Barn 400 to visit us and our horses. Also, please stop by and visit Brian Hickman at the American Home Club. He knows a lot of history, and I'm sure you'll find it very interesting. Thank you.
Let's get a big round of applause for the Alabama Morgan Horse Club, our green spotlight here.
Great job, Brianna. Great job.
Thank you.